Hello everybody, I am Dr. Bharti, working as an assistant professor of law at National University Delhi. Today I'll be discussing a module on informal access to justice. The objective of this module is to understand the various modes of informal access to justice, how they originated in Indian society and evolved over a year and reached to a present form of informal access to justice mechanism. We will also try to understand what are the advantages and disadvantages of these informal modes of dispute resolution. At last, and in end, we will try to understand a critical insight into the manner and mechanism of panchayat forms of dispute resolution mechanism. There have been countless extra informal mechanisms which have been existing from time immemorial and references to which predates the colonial rule, and that traces its origin to the laws of Rigvedic Aryavrat. Some of these mechanisms were lost in the sand of time, while others, very little in number, has been amalgamated into the already existing copious load of legislation. First of all, we will try to understand the benefits of informal mode of dispute resolution system. The most important benefit of informal access to justice system is it is very economic. In such mode of dispute resolution, no heavy court fees is provided, no stamp fees is provided, so it is very expensive and it is within the reach of every person despite of his economic resources. Another advantage of informal access to justice system is it is as easily accessible. It need not to follow any technical procedure, and it generally disposes of a dispute on the basis of justice, principle and equity. So it is within the understanding of the litigant which refer their dispute to such dispute resolution mechanism. Third advantage of this mode of dispute resolution is it is less technical. Fourth advantage of this mode of dispute resolution is it speedily disposes of the suit. As we already discussed, that this mode of dispute resolution mechanism need not to follow the technical procedure, so generally it saves the time and the dispute which is referred by the parties is disposed of in a short span of time. Last but not the least, the most important advantage of this dispute resolution mechanism is the amicable settlement of dispute between the parties. Here, it is not like who has done wrong, but more stress is given on disposing of a dispute, and at the same time relationship between the parties is also preserved. So generally when parties get their dispute settled through informal mode of dispute resolution, it leads to amicable settlement of dispute with which no enmity crops up between the party. To start with, we will try to understand the historical overview of the informal access to justice system in India. Dispute resolution has always been an essential component of Indian society. The earlier reference to the concept of the informal dispute resolution mechanism could be found in Dharmashastra. The Dharmashastra also dealt with non-adversarial indigenous method of dispute resolution. Samiti was another body of general deliberations where all kind of policy matter were discussed. This body also discharged legislative and judicial function. The most important function of Samiti was the election and re-election of the king. The king considered himself duty bound to participate in the deliberation of the Samiti and thus emerged to be the sovereign body. Another such bodies involved in informal dispute resolution was Sabha and Khula. The Sabha was another body engaged in dispute resolution at that time. It consisted of selected person and presided over by a king. Sabha was the national judicature due to the reason that the resolution of the Sabha was considered to be binding on all the person. Since caste was a predominant factor, therefore Khula was specifically formed to address the dispute which occasioned between various caste and tribes. Yajnavalkya and Arthashastra also mentions about existence of informal mode of dispute resolution. Even the great scholar Yajnavalkya, who in his work Yajnavalkya Smriti or the treatise on Veda have given reference of specialized courts which were constituted to dispose of dispute of informal nature. Other such courts which were established by the indigenous for the expeditious and informal disposal of dispute were established on the basis of nature of dispute. Reference to courts such as Shrimi and Puga have been made in Yajnavalkya. Arshastra also mentioned the significance of dispute resolution mechanism and laid down the procedure of dispute resolution. Parishad was another such body which was engaged in the functioning of informal dispute resolution mechanism. At that time, Parishad was an advisory body on religious matter, but it also discharged some judicial functions. It dealt with matters exclusively pertaining to dispute between the traders, merchant, farmers, bankers and guilds. The Parishads were often the association which were formed by the members of the particular trade or guild or business. It used to decide cases on the basis of principle of justice, equity and good conscience and customary laws. During the Mughal rules, even during the period of Mughal rule, disputes were often resolved by Mahajans who were experienced men from various guilds and often spent time by going to the places where dispute had arisen. They were the first ever known people to provide justice at the doorstep of the people. The system had a combination of two elements, mediation as well as arbitration. The Mahajan tried to resolve the dispute and see if the parties would reach a common ground. However, if the same was not arrived at, the Mahajan was empowered to pass an order to reach at a more equitable determination and arrive at an order which was based on principle of justice, equity and good conscience. Another such mode of informal access to justice was village elderly men. From time immemorial, a few elderly village men who were widely respected in the society were always called upon to convene a meeting near a religious place, usually a raised platform of a temple or a mosque or at some other public places, in order to bring out an amicable settlement of dispute existing between the parties. Reason for referring such dispute to such elderly people is their acquaintance with the people. Such elderly people were from the community itself in which the dispute has arisen. So the parties who are disputing and has referred the matter before them were known to them. Secondly, knowledge of the real dispute to these elderly people, as they are the people who are generally called for settling such dispute which arises in the community, they are in a better position to understand the real cause of such dispute, which is not only prevailing in this particular dispute, but has already arisen and has already existed in many other disputes which had already been referred to them. Thirdly, the relationship which that elderly person had with the people who has referred the dispute to them, they used to possess very respectable position in the eyes of the community. So, whatever they used to say to settle the dispute was taken in a very respectable manner by the person who has referred the dispute to such elderly person. Their vast experience of settling a dispute existing in the society used to give sanctity to their orders. The law which they used to apply for settling the dispute which is referred to them by the community people was not very technical, and they used to settle the dispute on the basis of principle of justice, equity and conscience. The subject matter of these elderly people court was very wide, from distribution of land to the claim of ownership on cattle, from determining the village and the field areas to small trifle matters or family dispute. All such matters were referred to these elderly people. The source of authority behind the order passed by them was the respect which such elderly people used to possess in the eyes of community people. Out of respect, the disputing party used to abide by the order passed by the elderly person. And the sanction which such order used to possess was the outcasting from society. If any person who has referred the dispute to such elderly court, and if elderly person has settled the dispute and passed an order, if such disputing party does not obey and abide such order out of respect, then there were chances and practices of outcasting such person from the community to which they belong. So the fear of being outcast was the sanction behind the order of the elderly men passed in his court for settling the dispute referred to him. This informal mode of settlement of dispute had influence even on the religious mind, which is evident from the saying of some of the religious person, like, according to Lord Buddha, mediation brings wisdom. Lack of mediation leaves ignorance. Know well what leads you forward and what holds you back. Choose that which leads to wisdom. Similarly, Parashar and Patanjali have also said that progress comes swiftly in mediation for those who try hardest, instead of deciding who was right and who was wrong. After understanding the historical overview of the informal mode of dispute resolution mechanism,